Weekly update time here at GoJacks.com. Head football coach John Stiegelmeier with us with the second round of the FCS playoffs looming on Saturday, a 2 o'clock matchup with Northern Iowa. The game and all that stuff we'll get to in a moment. Let's just begin with this past week and Thanksgiving. And what was it like for the football program over the holiday?
Well, it was super. Number one, I'm thankful for all we get around here and all we, all you know, our players, our, the family support, the administration support. We had Thanksgiving as a team Tuesday night. We practiced Wednesday, sent them home, emailed the families. They got a ton of emails back. Thanks for sending our sons home. So it was really a cool situation.
And that's maybe the most overlooked part of the bye is, yes, you get a week to heal and to prepare, but on top of it, you get a chance for a lot of these guys to get home and see their families for the first time in a long while.
Yeah, well, they no doubt. And we had guys flying back to Florida. I mean, they really made an effort to see their families. And one of the cool things about our program is we have so much family support when we play. And so they do get to see their families game week many times. But it was renewing for everybody.
And then what was sort of the weekend like for this team? Did they get together and watch the Northern Iowa game, or kind of how did you handle things Saturday and Sunday?
Brought them back Saturday, had some snacks for them, went up to Club 71, had the game projected on a screen, and we watched the first half together. And then we really went to work. We had a practice Saturday night, did mostly conditioning because of the time off.
All right, we look to Northern Iowa, and this is the unique situation that this is not a new opponent. It's somebody you know very well. You played them, obviously, in the regular season. So what is the preparation like for a team that you know so well?
Well, I think it's a little easier, to be honest with you. You know, we've studied them, we've game planned against them. We watched the film. We've watched all the film before we played them. We watched the film after we played them. You tweak some things, but it bottom line, football is 11 guys doing their job, and the 11 that do the job the best have success.
The first time you played Northern Iowa, it's well documented. It was just sort of a Murphy's Law situation in the first quarter, fell behind 17-0, and then just couldn't really get things going again. Have you gone back and watched that game? Do you take a lot from that moving forward? Is that one you kind of wipe away? What's been the philosophy of the first meeting as you prepared for this one?
You know, we never really watch game film. That game is part of our breakdown, both offensively, defensively, and special teams. It has to be. I mean, that's your opponent. But, I mean, you have to pay attention to the North Dakota State game. You have to pay attention to the University of South Dakota game, what they changed, how they've evolved. They're doing the same thing for us.
And you speak of you and I evolving, and they really have, because they are a much different team beginning with when they played you forward to what they were in the first half of the season.
Well, you know, Coach Farley does a great job of taking a team, and maybe they struggled to start. They've done that a number of years, and getting them ready to play their best football. And you can do that in the Missouri Valley, because if you finish strong in the Missouri Valley, you're going to make the playoffs. If you're playing great football, you got a chance to make a run.
We speak of that evolving. Marcus Weimiller had barely played the first few games of the year, had been injured. He made an appearance against South Dakota State, kept getting the ball, and became the workhorse the second half of the season. You've had a chance to watch a lot of him, obviously. What stands out to you about the way that Weimiller runs?
He's a football player. I mean, when I say that, and what is that? That's he plays hard. He runs hard. He reads his keys. I don't know if he's going to outrun a bunch of guys, but he's going to get yards when there's yards to be gotten. I mean, they put it on as a halfback. He's their wildcat quarterback. He's a really good football player.
And Eli Dunn at quarterback, maybe he's been overlooked a little bit in the second half of the season because of Weimiller, but he's a very efficient, very effective quarterback.
Eli Dunn is a very good quarterback, and they get lost sometimes because there's so many really good quarterbacks in the Missouri Valley, but he runs the show. He runs the RPO stuff to perfection. He's got some really good receivers, really good tight ends. Not as much a running threat, but he doesn't need to be because they use the Wildcat to do that.
We use the term opportunistic to describe defenses a lot, maybe almost too much, but you look at how many turnovers they force, how good the Panthers are at making interceptions. They're not dropping balls when they have opportunities. This is a defense that has capitalized on so many turnovers and a big reason why they've won as many games as they have.
And that starts with their front four. I mean, they've got a front four that's very physical. They can get a pass rush. They can knock you around on the run and again get the ball out. Their linebackers, starting out with Coach Farley's son, are really good. And so, I mean, it's a good defensive football team.
You mentioned Jared Farley, one of the best linebackers in the nation this year.
Yeah, Jared Farley is, again, he's a football player, and he mimics his dad. He's a mirror of his dad. His dad is intense. You can tell this young man's intense, and he's a physical guy. He plays hard. He runs the show. And again, I will always be a coach that says, I love watching guys. I love competing against guys like that.
Special teams played a big role in that game you played here in Brookings a couple of months ago that you and I won, and no doubt it'll play a big role again on Saturday.
Well, in the playoff, it's one and done, really. You know, you got it's, we talk about being 1-0. If you're not 1-0, you put your pads away. And so we better take the field as a football team, whether it's special teams, whether it's a PAT, we better take the field and know this play is going to impact the game.
One last point on Northern Iowa, the win over Monmouth. They dominated their opening round FCS playoff game. You mentioned the team got together and watched the first half. What jumped out to you? What were you most impressed with in that performance by you and I?
You know, early, Monmouth got some yards, you know, but you and I hung in there. Again, they're at home. It was their home crowd. And I just thought they just were consistent. They didn't panic, and they made plays. They made big plays. You talked about turnovers. They had a bunch of turnovers and impacted the game. So they have the benefit of having played a game but not having been spent. And so, in a sense, they may be a little bit ahead of us in terms of physical preparation.
Saturday, having this game at home, what does it mean to you and your team?
Well, it means we're a top 8 seed or the fifth seed. I mean, that's a credit to our players and what we've done during the season. It's an opportunity for our fans to show up and impact the game, and it's going to be a beautiful day. So I hope there's 15,000 people here. I know maybe people think that's a stretch, but why not?